Hi friends, in this video we are gonna cover command execution at a high level. So just like other levels, low and medium level, if you try to concatenate arbitrary commands with the symbols like ampersand or pipe or double ampersand or semicolon or such other variables symbols which I use for concatenating the commands, you'll find that this time it doesn't work. And the reason being it doesn't work is the proper sanitization of input this time. So if we try to do the things which we did, if we try to do such things which we did in the previous levels, we find that that's not working. So if we try with semicolon, it's also not working. Let's try other ones as well, and that's also not working. So nothing is working, and the reason is the input is sanitized well. So if we see the source code of it, we'll find that what the programmer is doing is taking this IP input to this variable target and then stripping slashes so that the attacker cannot escape special characters. Next thing what it is doing is splitting it into 4 octets. That means if we pass an IP like this, it will first divide it into 4 octets based on it will divide into 4 octets and based on this dot. So now there will be an array octet. There will be an array or list which is gonna store these elements. The 0th index will contain this 127, the first index will contain 0, second will 0, and the third will contain 1. So now now the programmer is checking if each octet is an integer or not. That means all octets are checked if these are numbers or not. And if they all are numbers, the programmer is reassigning them and reassembling them with dots and concatenating them and then just simply running the program. That means programmer has put on a good effort on good effort is put by the programmer to sanitize the input, and in this case this doesn't seem to be vulnerable, and that's what you have to do when you are designing such things where there is a possibility of remote code execution. So you have to be very strict on it, and you have to sanitize the input very well. So if I say the remote code execution at high level is not vulnerable, and in fact all of these vulnerabilities by 2005 are made impossible for high level. That means for the known time, and none of the vulnerabilities are none of the vulnerabilities are exploitable at a high level. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and if you like it, please subscribe to my channel at MyRealGhost.